Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. So good to have you guys back here again. Thank you once again for your continuous massive and huge support to this channel. God bless you my people, and we pray that even as you support this channel, God Almighty will support you in whatsoever you lay your hands to do, in Jesus name, amen. Thank you once again guys. Yes, we are back again with more update regarding the forthcoming election. We know the closest is the Edo State Governorship election that is slated to hold next Saturday, 19th of September, and a lot of persons are interested, persons in this Edo State Governorship election. Right now, my people, the news we're getting is that NNPP chieftain and Gbangboshe sent a strong warning to INEC. They've stated that don't listen to APC, Tinubu and Oshomole. We know very well that Oshomole is one of the biggest backbone and supporter of the All Progressive Congress, APC. Pastor Saige Ize-Iyamo, the connection with Tinubu, as Wajubola Tinubu, himself and Oshomole, they have some sort of tie. People have stated that it might be linked to 2023 race. That's the connection. Anyways, they've been urged not to listen to, INEC has been urged not to listen to APC, Tinubu and Oshomole ahead of the governorship election. We'll bring you all of the details shortly, but before we do, guys, please, if you haven't given us a thumbs up yet, my people, show us some love. Go ahead and give us a thumbs up. Click on the like button and don't forget to subscribe as well. Thank you once again. Really does mean a lot to us. We'll go straight into the news now and we'll grab all of the details. Edo Ondo elections. Don't listen to APC, Tinubu and Oshomole. NNPP chieftain and Gbangboshe wants INEC. Olusegun Gbangboshe, a chieftain of the New Nigerian People's Party, NNPP, has warned the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, against being used by the All Progressive Congress, APC, to influence the forthcoming governorship election in Edo and Ondo states. The governorship election in Edo state comes up on September 19th, while Ondo will decide their next governor in October. Gbangboshe noted that the two elections will actually be very tough in view of what is at stake. He pointed out that the case of Ondo State, the incumbent governor Rotimi Akeredolu, who is the candidate of the APC, would want to come back for a second tenure at all costs. The senior lawyer also mentioned other factors, as that of Asiwaju Bola Tinubu, who will want to impress President Muhammadu Buhari and the party by delivering Ondo in view of his perceived presidential ambition. In the case of Edo State, Gbangboshe noted that a former national chairman of the APC, Adams Oshomole, will equally flex his muscle to prove to the party that he's still a force to reckon with. He will want to tell Governor Obaseki that his godfatherism has not expired. The bottom line of these analysis is that the possibility of free and fair election in Ondo and Edo governorship election may be very slim, he said in a chat with Daily Post on Saturday. APC has planned to win the two governorship elections at all costs. The desperation is obvious. They are already perfecting plans to emerge winners, not minding what it will take them. We have reasons to believe that the pressure is being mounted on INEC to be part of the winning strategy. They are not leaving any stone unturned to win the election through any means possible. However, our party, New Nigerian People's Party, NNPP, will want to urge INEC to resist every temptation to be used as an instrument to subvert and subdue the will of the majority. Democracy has come to stay. INEC should avoid being tagged as enemy of democracy, EOD. They should not allow APC to circumvent democracy. We are not ruling out financial inducement by APC in order for the election to favor them, but INEC should be informed that Nigerians are watching them with keen interest whether INEC will dance to the tune of the ruling party. The will of the majority must prevail. That is what democracy is all about. INEC should maintain their integrity and ensure that democracy is not demonized by political desperados. This should not be influenced by the carrot APC may be dangling at them. Money is not everything. Nigerians should by now have known that APC as a party has no reasonable plan to develop this country. They are interested in clinching to power for their selfish aims, not really to alleviate the suffering of the poor masses. Nigerians should reject them and embrace NNPP. APC has lost focus and forthrightness. Our party remains the hope of better nation and better future, he said. So guys, and one would think that all of this is coming from the People's Democratic Party. You know, the major the battle is actually between the two major political parties in the country. We know that APC and PDP, they are the main political party. But this is coming from NNPP. They have stated that APC does not have anything to offer to Nigeria. They don't have any plan of developing the country. They don't have any plan of even alleviating the suffering of the poor masses. It's just to enrich their own pocket. So they've advised Nigerians to embrace NNPP. Anyway, guys, but the main thing they've stated here today is that INEC should not give in. They should not yield themselves as an instrument to manipulate the forthcoming election. And it's quite shocking that NNPP have spoken against APC. They have not said anything against PDP. It's APC they've spoken about. So it looks like they believe that, or they have an understanding what APC can do, how they've been rigging elections in the past. Probably that's where this chieftain is speaking from. So it's urging INEC not to give in once again. And Nigerians are watching. They should ensure a free, credible and fair election this time around. That they know very well that APC, they are very desperate for the two elections that are forthcoming, Ondo and Edo State, for Akeredolu to return. We know just recently we got a news that INEC office in Ondo State was on fire. Quite interesting. Just a couple of weeks to the election and all the card readers were burnt. Who was behind it? We don't know. They've stated that investigations are going on. But you see this rigging thing. Let's honor democracy that we talk about. Let's give them democracy a chance in the country. We want to hope that INEC will hear to this warning from NNPP. Guys, let us know what you think down below in the comment section. Thank you once again for coming out here. Thank you for staying tuned. Please, if you haven't given us a thumbs up yet, do give us a thumbs up. Click on the like button and don't forget to subscribe as well. Hit on the subscribe button. It really does mean a lot to us. Till I come your way again with more updates, it's bye for now and God bless.